Hi and welcome to my farm. I'm Max Lemayen. I'm from Sweden, but also active here in Kenya, where we are practicing agroforestry in permaculture design. And this chamber behind me, we are doing some tree planting, and we also have some grass that is for during drought season. So it's a backup kind of chamba land for the goats and sheep and cows. In this chamba, we have planted a few olive trees. Here locally, they call this one ingeriyoi, and Maasai they call it Oloirien. And the value, the use, all of that I've learned from the Maa-speaking communities, the Maasai, Samburu, Chamos, as I've been staying with them for some years. So I like planting this tree. Actually, this is most likely my favorite tree. It has a lot of uses. Even when you research this community traditionally, it has a lot of uses. So this is a tree, I think it's 4 years old. It could be taller than this, but most likely it has been disturbed a bit during that drought periods. We do let animals here. Then we have not really improved the ground here with digging. We have not really improved so much with manure. The first benefit that we get is when the tree is, let's say it's 2 or 3 or 4 years old. We can now prune it. And from a pruning like this, we get two things. These leaves are perfect fodder for cows, perfect fodder for goats. Even in the droughts, they are still green. And traditionally, that is actually what has kept animals alive during a dry spell. Because during a dry spell, the grass, even if the grass is there, will not give a lot of nutrition. And then, something like, so like half of this is for the animals. Then, something like this can be cut and made into a toothbrush. And this tree is very, very hard tree, so you don't want the tree to be too big. You cannot use a branch like this because it's so big, you cannot make to chew. And then you chew the end of it to be soft, and then you will just use to brush your teeth. And from staying with these Maa communities, I've really learned the importance of this mswaki. And among our trees that we have that produce mswaki, this is the one that we like because the test is good and then it's strong. And if you want your teeth to be really white, you put some charcoal from this tree and then having this mswaki and then you brush. We can go also to see a bigger one, so come and see. So this is also 4 years old. Maybe here it has more water, now it has grown faster. And the bigger branches we prune, chop chop, and it makes now a very straight tree. It could actually be harvested now, if you want. And you'll get a very good walking stick, something like this. Very hard when it comes from this tree. It can be a long stick or whatever. You can also make the rungu. It is a very, very strong wood. If you let it to grow, if we let it now to grow a little bit bigger, we can make now that stick for the djembe, and it will last for many years. It is a very, very strong tree compared to the stick that you buy in the store. So it has some uses. If we let it to grow some years again, we'll get a post from this. A post we can use in fencing, a post we can use in house construction, and it does last long because this one is not eaten by termites so much, and it's a very strong tree. We are going to plant many of them. We have now tried, and we see it's doing well. It's growing a little bit slower than the other trees, some of the other trees, but the value is very big. Then if it grows together with other trees, like this is a Cespania cespan, and this is a Morbaine nusu, the Melia. When it grows like this, it also helps that tree to be straight. So we have seen it actually, when it's young, it likes to be in the shade. These smaller branches that does not give us any of the mswaki or fimbo, we leave them. Because this chamber here, seasonally we have those animals. So they will come and graze. And this tree is now tall enough that they will not reach the top of it. So it can survive grazing. There's another tree that is prone to grazing, so we can go and see what we do. This is another ingeriyoi. And it has been grazed, whereby it is not growing as tall as the other ones. So what we try to do, we prune this Cespania cespan and other trees, and then we try to fence it locally. And it creates a microclimate, some small shade for it, but it also protects from those goats. Although this one has been eaten a little bit, I'll have to add these ones. But it's a very nice tree. We want to plant many of them to be big. If they are big, we will also get firewood from the pruning. If the sticks are not straight enough to be a fimbo or a whatever, as we make those sticks for the fence or construction, those remains will be a very perfect firewood. And it has a very good charcoal. And the charcoal is a very nice medicine, whereby they have been, that is the tree now they've been using to clean the calabashes, so that charcoal can be keeping milk fresh. Or if you want it to become sour milk, morsik, or kolenauto, that this charcoal from this tree, the olive, will make now the tree to the milk to go to be a good sour milk, and it will prevent molding. Again, when the tree is bigger, we can also harvest bark from the prunings, and the bark is a very good dewormer and medicine for other things. So it's one of my very, very favorite trees. Even the bees, they like, yeah, it's a good tree. But you cannot just plant that tree anywhere. This tree likes a little bit of bush, like here. It already has big trees, and you have to really protect it well from the grazing animals, because they love this tree. The favorite of all of them. So I hope you learned something new from these experiences that I've had over the years planting this tree. If you like this kind of content, you can freely check my YouTube channel. I have a lot of things like this from my farm, even from staying with the Ma people. If you have another knowledge about this tree, even to how to grow it, how to plant it, how to take care of it, how to prune, how to use it, please feel free to comment. If you have other questions, feel free to comment. So I thank you so much for your time.